Hello guys, welcome to Robotic Electronics, and let's start our discussion. In the previous video, we have looked into a couple of definitions like what is variable, elements, observations, data, data set, and all. And now let us look into further vocabulary of some basic statistics. So what is variable? It is a characteristics of an item or an individual. For example, height of students, weight of students in a class, or some weight of a mechanical part in a car, all these come under variables. And next, data. Data is a different values are associated with a variable or with variables. So data is a, we can say data is a plural or a singular. So you can use data is or data are. There is not much difference in it. Okay. So data are different values are associated with a variable or with variables. So let us look at some basic vocabulary of statistics. So you have got a population, there is something called a sample, and there is something called a parameter, and there is something called statistics. So what do you think? What is population? Just think for a while. What is population? So, population is basically all the items or individuals about which you want to draw conclusions. For example, let us say you want to know the income of those people who live in 25 kilometers radius from the center of the city. And the age of those people should be between 18 to 25. Okay. So, all those people who are in this age group and live in this 25 kilometers radius, that would be the population. Let us say, population for simplicity is, so all this one are individuals are population. Okay, all the individuals obeying the characteristics, that is the age between 18 to 25, come under this population. Okay, so what is sample? Sample is a proportion of population selected for analysis. So we will select some part of the population, like say 100 people, so that 100 people from the population, so that we can know the income of the entire population. So how to select a sample? It should be representative sample. Okay, for example, in the set of 100 people, let us say there are 75 males and 25 females, and let us say we are taking a sample of example, let us say 20. So if you are taking 20 sample over here, then how many should be male? 75% are male, right? So it must be 0.75 into 20, right? So whatever is a number you will get, right? Similarly 0.25 into 20, so these many females you should select, and these many males you should select. So that's why you will have a representative sample. What if there is no representative sample? You cannot draw conclusions based on the sample correctly, and you can not assume the characteristics of population well. So there must be a certain ratio of the sample you have to take from the population. So the sample you have taken must be representative. A representative sample means the sample should have the same characteristics which the population has got. So that's why you are doing the 75% of male, that is 20 into 0.75, so that this many males I want in my sample, and 0.25 into 20, so that this many females I want in my sample. So you are making a sample more similar characteristics to the population for our better analysis further. So parameter. So parameter is a numerical measure that describes characteristics of the population. Is the characteristics of the population, not the sample. Okay. So it could be, let us say, population mean, or it could be standard deviation of the population. Statistics is a measure that describes the characteristics of sample. Okay. Statistics is a measure that describes the characteristics of sample. Whereas parameter is a, describes the characteristics of population. Okay. So this is just one more slide on population sample. So this is your entire population. So population measures used to describe the population are called parameters. So these measures which you use to describe the population are called parameters, and those measures which we need to describe the sample are called statistics. Okay. So there are some certain benefits of doing sampling from the population. It saves time. You can easily take few samples from the population and perform whatever analysis you want to perform. Let us say if you want to measure height, measure it. If you want to take a measure weight, measure it, right? It is of course less expensive because you are approaching only few ones from that population. It is good to go for sampling when your population is large, and I have already mentioned when your population is very very large and you can't make a analysis on entire data. It will take much time. It is very expensive. You must have very good RAM and processor for making analysis on large data. So you just take a sample and perform this. Okay, you can reduce time. You can reduce your expenses. So this type of sampling is very useful in making analysis. So there are certain types of variables. We have already studied what is variable. So variable is a characteristics of an individual in which we are interested. For example, height of a student, right? Did you recollect it? Or let us say weight of students in our class. So you have variables in two forms, categorical and numerical. Either it can be categorical or numerical. Also, either you can call it non-numerical or numerical. Or you can also call it as a quantitative and qualitative. Okay, you can also call it as metric data or a non-metric data. Okay, so let us say male, female, it is nothing but metric. Let us say you would have seen people having 10 cups of coffee every day. So you can call them heavy coffee drinker. You know what medium coffee drinker, right? So heavy, medium, they are nothing but categorical variables. We can say, let us say group 1 and group 2 categorical variables, B first year class, B second year class, these are categorical variables. Okay, and again numerical variables are further divided into discrete and continuous. And you can also see the examples of categorical here, like marital status, are you married or no, it is categorical. And political party, we have good political parties like TRS, TDP, Congress, BJP. All these are categorical. And eye color. And there are eye colors like blue, orange, like blackish or blackish brown. All these are categorical variables. So let us come to numerical and discrete. The number of children are very discrete, right? Discrete in the sense we can count them. Number of children, like we can say 2, 3 or 4. And defects per hour. If you are manufacturing a certain product in your company, like you will be dealing with the defects per hour, so you will be counting them. And let's go to the continuous. Continuous is like weight, voltage, height. You can't measure it very precisely.